establish shall not defeat it. So when you enter in the house of God, because the gates of hell have no power to defeat it, you find those demons
to
flee before, because of the power of
Rachel
that is talked about in Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 9.
Anasema uweza wa kifalme.
He said the power of kingdom.
Ulikuwa mabegani mwake.
It was upon his shoulder.
Shauri wa ajabu.
A wonderful counselor.
Mungu mwenye nguvu.
Mighty God.
Baba wa milele.
Everlasting Father.
Falme wa amani.
Prince of peace.
Tuna baba wa milele.
We are an everlasting Father.
Baba wa hapa duniani.
The Father of this world.
Hata kikupenda namna gani.
He loves you at any time.
Lakini kuna kikomo.
But there is an obstacle.
Baba yangu mimi alikuwa ananipenda.
How God loved us so much.
Baba yangu mimi alikuwa na watoto 13.
Her father had 14 children.
Katika watoto 13.
Among the 13 children.
Alinipenda mimi kuliko wote.
He loved more than any child.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lakini baada ya muda mfupi.
But after a short while.
Nilikaa naye miaka 20
tu. I was still with him for 20 years
only. Na akaondoka.
And he left.
Lakini huyu baba.
But this father.
Tunayeongea habari.
Which we're talking about this morning.
Ni baba wa milele.
He is an everlasting father.
The
Father shall continue to be there. The one that have in the world, I don't know in heaven. I shall be meeting my one in the
world.
Or shall be on the other side. And God shall be on the other side. Because the Bible says, when you are raptured, we shall put on your body, and it shall be like the angels. And God shall ask the people, is someone saving the wives? When he comes to heaven, this one, who will you be the husband to?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now Jesus says, you don't understand. When you are raptured, you'll be like the angel. It means when I'm raptured, you are a father to have, you'll be like someone just like me. You'll be just like an angel. But you don't have a relationship of relatives. We don't have relationships when you go into heaven. Because all of us shall be like one family. All of us shall be siblings. And relatives only here in the world. It's only for a short while. And that's why it's very important to believe. It's very important to take
messages.
Because it's only for a short while. Into an everlasting life. Me and you cannot do that. Mingo. When you talk mingo. Into eternity. I'm your sister. You're my brother. You're my father. All of us are one family. The family of the world. We are living them here on earth. We are living here upon the
graveyard.
Now God is reminding you. Through Isaiah. He's the father of eternity. He's the king of eternity. Who will rule over our lives on earth. He said he's a wonderful counselor.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where's he called Christo?
You can't be a Christian.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Kama mshauri hayupo.
If the counselor is not there,
mshauri lazima awepo.
The counselor has to be there.
Yeye ndiye anayetuongoza.
He's the one that leads us. He's the one that directs us.
Anatuongoza.
He's the one that leads you.
Jicho langu likipata.
But I am pursuing.
Wengine wanaona wokovu.
Many people are seeing salvation is so hard today.
Kwa sababu Yesu hayupo.
Because Jesus is not there.
Wengine wameokoka.
Many have gone again. There are many years of salvation.
Lakini ukweli.
But truly, they have remained only by his spirit. They remain in the language. Because the language is a gift. And it's not the Holy Spirit. They have remained in the language. But the language is not there.
Niliwaambia kwenye ibada iliyopita.
I told people in the past service.
Nina mtoto wa ndugu yangu.
I have my sibling's child.
Ambaye alijazwa Roho Mtakatifu.
He was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Wakati mimi ni mwalimu wa Sunday school.
When I was a teacher of Sunday school back then.
Mwaka wa 95.
It was like approximately 95.
96.
96 there.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Alijazwa Roho Mtakatifu vizuri.
He was filled with the Spirit of God.
Akiwa na miaka kama 6-7.
When he was like 6-7 years old.
Unajua mtoto hujawahi kukutana na mtoto aliyejaa Roho.
You have never met a child who's filled with the Spirit.
Wanasema mpaka unapenda.
They speak in tongues until when you
love. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lakini.
But.
Leo ameiacha njia.
Today he has forsaken salvation.
Lakini hata akiwa amelewa.
When he is drunk.
Ana kile kitu. kitabu kile cha Gideon.
He has the Gideon's Bible.
Kile kibibilia cha blue.
The small Bible Bible.
Wote tunakijua.
All of us have the small Bible.
Tunapewaga mashuleni.
You've been given back in school.
Kitabu huko mfukoni.
You can put in the pocket.
Wakati ameshakunywa pombe yake.
When he's so drunk.
Amevuta bangi yake amelewa.
He's taking his bangi drunk.
Bado ananena.
He's still speaking in tongues.
Analia wakati ananena.
And he cries when he's speaking in tongues.
Ananena ulevi sio Roho Mtakatifu.
He's speaking in tongues in
alcoholism.
The Holy Spirit left
wengi leo.
Many people today.
Roho Mtakatifu ameondoka.
The Holy Spirit has left.
Tumebaki na lugha.
You have remained in the language.
Tumezoea kunena.
We are used to speaking in tongues. But the form of the language is not there. This Christmas. We need to forget the language. So when you speak in tongues, you should come with this power. You should come with authority. To restore you. You can say that's why I'm speaking in tongues. Even the witch doctors speak in tongues. Even the witch doctors speak in tongues. Even those that have forsaken salvation speak in tongues. Because the God gives a gift, he does not remove it out from you. That's why they are pastors today, they are prophets today, they are fornicating their lives, and they even stand upon the altars. They are fornicated at this time. At midday, they are at that two adultery. At 4 p.m., they are standing in the center. Why is it so? When God is a gift, the Lord must have for you. When He gives the language, He has given you. The language can be of the devil. But you can still confess of the Holy Spirit. Yet the Holy Spirit has left you long time away. The intention of that is not to put a new dress. The intention of Christmas is not to eat well. In verse 11.
Nobody panishia mstari wa 11.
Put for me in our verse 11.
Kwanzia ule wa 10.
From 10.
Hallelujah. Anasema.
It says.
Walipoiona hiyo nyota. Walifurahi mno. Basi wakaingia nyumbani. Wakamuona yule mtoto pamoja na Maria, mama yake. Wakapiga magoti, wakamsujudia. Kisha wakafungua hazina zao. Wakampa zawadi, wakampa dhahabu, wakampa ubani, wakampa na manemane. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Christmas.
Christmas.
Ni siku ya Yesu kuzaliwa.
Is the day of Jesus' birth.
Kwa Kiingereza tutasema ni birthday ya Yesu.
In English we say it's the birthday of Jesus.
Sio birthday yako.
It's not your birthday.
Sio birthday ya mume wako.
It's not your husband's birthday.
Sio birthday ya watoto wako.
It's your child's birthday.
Ni birthday ya Yesu.
It's the birthday of Jesus.
Walisikia habari.
When they heard
na mtoto yule
of a child.
Walifika kwenye nyumba.
They came into the manger.
Wakiwa na zawadi.
When they heard the gift.
Kwenye nyumba ya nani?
In this house.
Kwenye nyumba ya Bwana.
In the house of God. We have turned Christmas to be of our
own.
Even those that believe in Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Saizi,
right now.
Let's
not have the court of Christmas.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Even the other Muslims.
Saizi,
right now, there's not any
court of Christmas.
Today, there's not any court. Even my relatives, my friends in the street. And there are the shops nearby. And the Alice place. Today is their
Christmas.
They have gone to Serengeti to eat Christmas today. They are in the Moslem.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because
of the twisters of Christmas.
It
has changed the book of God. We are thinking Christmas is easy. We are thinking Christmas to put the new
place.
But Christmas
is
a day to enter the house of God. It's a day to know to change the birth of Jesus. What should I do for him?
Kama siku ya birthday ya mtoto wako unaweza kutengeneza keki.
If a part of your church can prepare cake.
Siku ya leo.
Today.
Nitakoseme jamani.
You can say, oh. Let it go by the light to put upon the tree. There was the where your treasure is. It's where your heart is.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Today is not our day. Today the owner exists. Someone is going to the market and says, but he has an offering of 1,000 shillings to give. I'm not saying 1,000 is bad. But the one of 1,000 is so you want the market to 100,000. You have bought from the cloth of 200,000 euros and you're king. The owner of the basket. It seems like this. You tell the basket in the house.
Alex.
I tell you, Alex. Welcome to my house every birthday. You have invited people. You have had people up now. You say, what's the food in my pastor's basket? You go and buy a good shirt in the town. You come to my bathroom looking good. You come empty-handed in the
bathroom.
What have you come to do? That's what the church is doing. We are there for the world. You are forgetting the owner of the bathroom. Today there is an owner.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
My gospel is praise. Hallelujah.
Kuna mtu anatamani kupiga rungu sawa tu.
My gospel is praise. Today there is an owner who exists. This gospel goes home, it's going back to my family. Is my family a sultan and go to
them?
They have prepared themselves. Nobody can come and serve before I go there. Hallelujah. Today the press opened
that
feast. With all the relatives I'm invited. In my family, half a Muslim, half a Christian. The gospel will be preached at home. Because they can't run away today. They don't know. But the gospel is going to release today. Right now they are celebrating. They are slaughtering the goats.
And
I'm happy they are slaughtering. But the goats will have run away from church today. It's
going
to be three times. Because rivers will fall there. He's not the one here. I'm
trying to do it.
I have the gospel of the marbles.
Na moto.
And fire.
Ndio injili itakayokwenda kushuka baada ya muda mfupi.
It's the one that will release after a short while.
Hiyo hata kama ulikuwa umetenda dhambi lazima uanze kutubu.
Even that one if you have committed a sin, you can start to repent.
Kuna zile injili za kutisha za kulola.
Because those are gospel the corollas.
Wakati huwa zinakuaga na mahali pake.
It has its own place to release.
Sherehe ni.
This celebration.
Ina mwenyewe.
It has its owner.
Ni Yesu Kristo.
It's Jesus Christ.
Birthday hii.
This birthday.
Si ya kwetu.
It's not ours.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ina mwenyewe.
It has Jesus Christ. He is the owner of this birthday. We are assembling here to remember what Jesus did.
Our
Lord Jesus Christ upon the cross and the power that was there before he was born. Because the Bible says before he existed upon the foundation of the world, he was there. I knew you. No matter time I tend to look.
Anaweza akaja mtumishi akahubiri.
A servant of God can come and preach.
Akakwambia.
He can tell you.
Unajua jina lako unatakiwa ubadilishe.
You're supposed to change your name.
Kwa sababu jina lako ni baya.
Because your name is bad.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jina lako ni utapeli.
Your name is in the resembles conscience.
Unaitwa Yakobo.
You are called Jacob.
Wewe ni utapeli tu.
You are a con man.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Unaitwa Mariam.
You're called Mariam.
Sasa ninakwenda kukubatiza.
Now I'm going to baptize your new name.
Unatakiwa uitwe Esther.
You're supposed to be called Esther.
Ni kweli kuna watu walibadilishwa majina kwenye Biblia.
It's true that people have been changed their names in the Bible.
Kwa makusudi maalum.
By the true intention.
Kuna watu majina yao.
There are people's names.
Yalikuwa yana maana ngumu.
They had very hard meaning.
Kwenye Biblia.
Into the Bible.
Kwa mfano Jabez.
For example, Jabez.
Jina la Jabez.
The name of Jabez.
Lilikuwa lina maana ngumu.
Very hard meaning.
Mtu wa huzuni.
Someone of sorrow.
Mtu asiyefanikiwa.
Someone does not prosper.
Lakini hatumuoni Jabez.
But you're not seeing Jabez.
Akibadilisha jina.
Changing his name.
Biblia inatuambia.
The Bible says.
Jabez alimlingana Mungu.
Jabez looked upon God.
Abadilisha hatima kwa sababu ya jina lake.
Changed his destiny because of
his name. Akaomba kwa bidii.
And he prayed diligently.
Na Bwana akapanua hema yake.
And God expanded his territory. That's why you have to hear the voice of the shepherd. This is somebody.
Anaitwa Mariam.
She's called Mariam.
Tuchukulie ni binti.
Let me take her, she's like a lady.
Nichukue binti kabisa. Sisi nikaja nikatabiri kitu ambacho.
Let me profess
something
that the real problem.
Huyu ni binti.
She's a lady.
Anaitwa Mariam.
She's called Mariam.
Tunasema wewe na kuitwa Mariam.
Because she can no be called Mariam.
Mariam ni jina la Kiislamu.
Mariam is a Muslim name.
Tunasahau kwenye Biblia.
We forget in the Bible.
Habari njema imesema Maria.
The good news says
that. Lakini Scripture Union bado imemuita Mariam.
But the good news says Mariam.
Sasa anakwenda kubatizwa.
Na she's gonna be baptized.
Ninamwambia Mariam.
I say Mariam.
Kuanzia leo utaitwa Esther.
From today you'll be called Esther.
Na anasema sawa mchungaji.
She says keep fast.
Ninamchukua Mariam.
I take Mariam.
Ninamtumbukiza kwenye maji.
I'm baptizing the water.
Inama basi mbona kwa kanguzo rafiki yangu. Inama ninamchuchumaa. Ninamtumbukiza kwenye maji.
I baptize the water.
Ananyanyuka.
When she rises.
Yeye ni Esther.
She's called Esther.
Sasa huyu.
Now this lady.
Anasoma.
She's still in school.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Anaweza kapia shule amemaliza kusoma.
Maybe she has finished studying.
Anafanya kazi ni mwalimu.
She's working as a teacher somewhere.
Mume wake ni mwanajeshi.
Her husband is a soldier.
Baba amepewa transfer.
The father's gone in transfer.
Dodoma.
She has gone to Dodoma.
Yeye yuko Arusha.
She's in Arusha.
Sasa anataka mpate mume Dodoma.
That's what's called the hubby in Dodoma.
Leta cheti cha ndoa.
Bring your marriage certificate.
Alipokuja pale.
When she came here.
Sija mfungisha ndoa kwa jina la Mariam.
I did not put her into marriage with Mariam. Nimefungisha
ndoa kwa jina la Esther.
She's married by using Esther.
Nimejaza cheti Esther.
I'll fill the certificate that's
Esther.
She goes with a certificate. She's looking for a transfer. She goes to the
hobby.
The school certificate. They say Mariam.
Hallelujah.
The husband.
Hallelujah. Cheti cha ndoa kama aliolewa kabla kinasema Mariam.
Before marriage is called Mariam.
Kama amechelewa kinasema Esther.
Maybe she's delayed, she's called Esther.
Anachukua kile cheti cha Esther.
She takes the Esther
certificate.
Anakipeleka
wizarani. Na vyeti vyake vya kazi.
And also I'm a
paper. Anaomba transfer.
She's asked for transfer.
Amfuate mume wake.
She goes to the hubby.
Nisaidieni kujaza.
Fill in the blank space.
Mbona mjazi?
How come you're not filling the blank space?
Hallelujah. Unaweza kuketi.
You can go and sit down.
Atapewa transfer na malipo yake kweli?
We should get a transfer with the whatever she's supposed to get. For a pastor to change the name, she's supposed to go and look for
affidavit.
She's supposed to go into the region of this other region.
She
has to go to Moshi.
To go
enough trips to Moshi. And to go through
registration.
To change her name. But someone just came from
somewhere.
He has changed his name.
From
Tyre to a little name.
Jesus
looked unto God.
He
should someone speak
everything.
But that's why you have a pastor. To tell you this is okay. Everyone can preach. And the anointing can come down. But not everyone has the proper understanding. Many people here today, when they get the transfer, the marriage certificate will reject them or reject them.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Bible says,
Mungu alikujua,
God knew you
kwa jina la Mariam,
by the name of Mariam.
Akikuita,
when he called you,
alikuita kwa jina la Mariam.
He called the name of Mariam.
Mimi nimekujua,
for me I have known you
kwa jina la Mariam,
by the name of Mariam. Because the Bible says, nobody goes to Jesus.
You have
been told by the Father. The Father knows you. He has called you. He has brought the
Father.
He knows you. That's why he calls you. I have no power to remove you. I have no power to pull you. God knows you by your name. If you knew my name of Esther,
I would have called
you. He knows you by the initial name. That name ain't be bad.
Or
let them be good. You have the power to go to God. You have the power to go to God. And look in the face of God. So that you may be able to change. Wherever it stops you. Because wherever it stops you, it's not in you. It's a spirit that exists upon that name. And
you
give him the power to trip over snakes and
scorpions.
And every power of the devil. And nothing shall harm you. Don't
look
at those people. But your power that is upon the name. Bishop Maboya says almost time. You can change your name John.
John.
Look into the prison and Johns are there.
Ya Arusha.
And there are prisoners who
share
the same name. There are Christians and Johns are there. The prison of Arusha. It has many Christians more than one of them. And all of them have the names that are in the Bible. What the disciples not the name.
It's
the spirit behind the name. You can see me change. Someone can say Mary, the meaning is bitterness. And if you're going to change, you don't know what the man of Jesus called Mary.
If
you have a spirit of truth, why is it a beauty? You cannot see anywhere in the man of Jesus. He's complaining.
For
lamenting.
The shared
bitterness the child is going upon the cross. Is nowhere.
Deliverance is getting too extreme.
Your deliverance goes beyond
extreme.
It goes into a place. Because people want tangible things. But the truth shall remain. The Bible shall remain to the Bible. My burden is mine. And my burden is not heavy. The things it doesn't put down. To make you desire to come to church. But it's not biblical. You have no reason to change your name. You have no reason. God knows you by your name. He died because of that name. He lived by that name. He called you by that name. He declared the victory by that name. Don't give up.
It's
not the name that brings you back. It's the power behind the name. The power of God has no boundary. The Bible says, when he went into the grave could not hold him. that many people that resurrected.
Yesu akuwa wa kwanza.
Jesus was not the first one.
Elia alifufua.
Elijah resurrected.
Elisha alifufua.
Elisha resurrected.
Hata Yesu mwenyewe alifufua.
Even Jesus himself resurrected.
Alifufua Jairus.
He resurrected Jairus.
Akamfufua pamoja.
He resurrected also Lazarus.
Wako waliofufuka.
There are many people that resurrected.
Lakini walikufa
tena. But they died again.
Lakini anasema mimi ni mzaliwa wa kwanza.
But I am the firstborn.
Katika wale waliofufuka.
Among the men that are dead. Of the barrier into the grave. Tell your neighbor. What the resurrection
ni kuokoka
is salvation.
Maana roho yako ilikuwa imekufa.
Because your spirit had died.
Ukaamua kufufuka kwa
Kristo. Una uwezo wa
kuanza
sana. You have the power to live along the barrier of
kaburini.
Upon the grave.
Ninakwambia sema na jirani yako.
I say speak to your neighbor.
Una uwezo wa kuacha sanda kaburini.
You have the power to remove the barrier of
cloth. Unaweza kubeba hiyo sanda.
You can carry the barrier of cloth.
Uje hapa kwa mchungaji Jennifer.
You can come to Pastor Jenny.
Na masawe.
Masawe.
Tukakemea.
You can rebuke.
Lakini una uwezo.
But you have the power.
Wa kuiacha kaburini.
Of living it in the grave. Because what you live
in. But Christ in
you.
Na ndipo ninapotamani.
That's when there is
a kanisa la Jesus.
The church of Jesus far to reach.
Hiyo sanda uiache kaburini.
To live alone and live in the grave. You come on the way you are.
Sanda uiache
kaburini. You live in the living into the grave.
Yesu aliiache kaburini.
Because Jesus left to pay into the grave.
Ni sisi ndio tunaamua kutembea na sanda.
It's us who desire to move with the linen cloth.
Tumeamua tu kabisa.
We have decided us.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Wakati mwingine
sometimes
hata shetani naye anaona na fly
with the devil he looks at you in his heart.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Anasema sasa hichi kitu hata akipo.
He said this is the
Lord like this. Lakini nionyeshe kwamba nipo.
But let me show myself that I exist.
Anaangalia anapiga darubini.
He takes look to the binocular.
Anamtafuta aliye dhaifu.
He looks at the weak
one. Anamvaa.
He attacks.
Akishamvaa.
After attacking.
Anamgaragaza hapo.
He puts you down.
Watu wote wakata wale kwa mesuba.
Wananyanyua mikono. They are raising up their hands.
Mtangazia ushindi for nothing.
We declare victory kwa ajili.
Hakuna ushindi zaidi ya Kristo.
There is no victory that Jesus on the cross.
Yesu alimaliza yote.
Jesus finished everything.
Alisema nimemaliza.
He said I finished
it. Ni kweli amemaliza.
Ukifika
mahali ukapo
kumjazuka.
Ni kweli umemaliza. Hakuna atakaye
kuonea.
Hakuna atakaye kukandamiza.
Nobody shall oppress you.
Hakuna atakaye kukandamiza.
Nobody shall oppress you.
Una uwezo wa kuzuia.
You have the power to stop.
Hata katika vitu vidogo vidogo.
Even into the small thing.
Una uwezo wa kuzuia.
You have the power to stop it.
Nguvu iko ndani yako.
There's a power in you.
Ukiamua kuiacha sana.
When you decide to leave the barrier of
cloth
upon the grave.
Na kujua kwamba.
And to know sure.
Yesu Kristo.
Jesus Christ.
Alikuja.
He came.
Na uwezo wa kifalme.
And the power of kingdom was upon his shoulder.
Na uwezo huo.
And that power.
Wewe uko mabegani mwako.
Is upon our shoulder.
Kristo anaishi ndani
yetu. Because Christ lives in us.
Ina maana sisi.
It means us. We're not the shoulder of Christ.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Anasema.
He says.
Isaiah 53:3.
Isaiah 53 from verse 3.
Anasema alidharauliwa.
Says he was despised.
Na kukataliwa na watu.
And he was rejected by people.
Mtu aliwaye sikitiko.
Someone knows the sorrow.
Hakika ameachukua.
Surely has taken.
Masikitiko yetu.
All our suffering.
Amejitwika huzuni zetu.
He has carried our depression.
Bali amejeruhiwa kwa makosa yetu.
But he was bruised because of our transgression. The punishment of our
yake.
It was considered unto him. And by his stripes
sisi
we were healed.
Johanna 10:10.
John 10:10.
Mimi nalikuja.
I came.
Ili wawe na uzima.
You may have life.
Kisha wawe nao tena.
Life in abundance.
Mimi ni mchungaji mwema.
I'm a good pastor.
Mchungaji mwema.
A good shepherd.
Hutoa uhai wake.
Gives his life.
Kwa ajili ya kondoo.
For his sheep.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Mimi ni mchungaji mwema.
I'm a good shepherd.
Unajua mimi huwa.
You know me.
Ninapenda kufanyia kazi.
I love to work upon.
Vitu ninavyofundisha.
The thing that I teach.
Wakati mwingine vinakuwa ni challenge.
Sometimes it can be a challenge.
Lakini mimi ninapenda kupita kwenye challenge.
But I love to pass through the challenges.
Kwa sababu ninapoishinda ile challenge.
Because when I overcome the challenge.
Unajua hata kama ni ya kijinga.
It is something very small.
Lakini ninajua hata ninaposimama mahali
popote.
Inaweza ikamsaidia mtu.
To help somebody.
Kuweza kuvuka.
To be able to cross over.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Nilipata allergy ya rangi.
I got an allergy by color allergy.
Allergy
to nail polish.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Miaka kama mitano.
5 years ago.
Sijapaka rangi kabisa.
I could not put any nail polish.
Is
that I don't like to put my nails on a polish. But I love to do it by myself. Recently I sat down. He said, I feel to put the nails in polish my nails. I polished my nails. The one that adopts me, I know how I can become. My hands itchy. They tend to itch until I get some bristles. Like 2 to 3 hours, it rose again. So they itching again. I told God, I've seen and understand. And I accepted. I will not smear any polish into my nails. But God, whenever I go to remove this nail, because of allergy, it means the devil has got an opportunity of reigning and ruling over me. The color
God,
I will not put it on because I don't want
it.
It's not because of the itch of the allergy. You know the itch has not
started,
and I still have it. They are my
legs.
They really itch. And I was speaking with
him.
The allergy this time. This layer, this body shall come at its own time. And the day when I feel not to smear again, when I see your hand is not involved,
it's
the day when I leave alone doing it and the polish. Don't disturb me for 1 minute or 2 hours.
Siku ya kwanza,
the first day,
siku ya pili,
the second day,
siku ya tatu,
the third day,
akaamua kuachia.
They had to leave it.
Hapa sisikii kitu.
I don't feel anything anymore. I'm okay right now.
Itaacha.
I will leave. The day when I decide by
myself.
What am I trying to say? We are led by the Holy Spirit. We are led by God. You are not a thing that we feel upon our body. Refuse the situation. Because he has said openly, I came that we have life. Life in abundance. The situation that you feel. Sometimes you continue to feel it. But you continue speaking to me. You continue speaking to me. That this is not your place. When you have a headache, you can use it. When you have diarrhea, you can use it. When you enter the
room,
when you smear, and you feel something is holding upon you after spraying mosquito, it's usually size. I'm not of the path of this world. Things of this world.
Side effects of the world.
The side effects of this world. They aren't my portion. It's a decision that you can take. They are so hard. And sometimes it pulls the pain. I'm not saying I'm not feeling the pain. I'm not saying when you feel the situation will be there and then. But the Bible says, reject the devil and it shall flee away from you. There's a time to flee of such a devil.
Constantly.
You continue on refusing
objection.
You know only one thing. He came that we have life and life in abundance. The headaches. I said, leave right now. You don't know even the
headache.
The headache is there.
But
you pretend it's not there. You pretend you're not hearing it. After 30 minutes, 1 hour, I guarantee 100% the pain will leave you. And that's what it
takes.
You feel the devil was
trying.
He's not very trying. He tries us. But when he tries us, we life and life in abundance. Trials come. He tests us. When he comes, he comes to find us standing firm. We are going to fight with him and to remove him out.
Hallelujah.
We fight with him. It's just like when the voice comes. Someone here may be having a sorrow.
Hallelujah.
Now this Christmas, the husband came at 5 a.m.
Hallelujah.
Not everybody is happy today. Others have sorrows today. Don't accept all those sorrows. You should surely when you get born again, you'll be serving your entire family. He came, he has woken up
the morning.
If he has
give
the soup over there. Give him also two bananas or fried
garlic.
Put a fried food also
a lot.
You're welcome. You see somebody confused, but
it's
confused. And then the king says,
you're a servant of God. Because you come,
but what
are the
food? I think you'll be handled. First of all, it's going to happen, not be having that
time.
And second, you'll not have the beer. You won't get a diabetes. God does not understand. God does not understand. What is this? How will I continue going on
with
this affliction? God says, those who have removed them from Egypt, because of the
is
the one that didn't destroy them. God wants to stand by his
word.
God wants to be born again into your life. He wants to conform you to
God.
So when people see you, they say, surely this man. They say it is father because it goes in two-way hand. It's not only the mothers that have problems. Even the fathers also have issues. Our difference is the mothers tend to announce, the fathers tend to go silent. Until the man tells you, I'm beaten. It is more than not easy. But the men and men who are beaten, even here, they're here. The men who are beaten.
Hallelujah.
But you have the power to overcome. The power exists. It exists.
Hallelujah.
And the born again is very hard.
You
know, born again to be born, salvation to born again. It's something easy. We went to a funeral recently. Just to touch that widow.
Kumuombe.
To pray for her.
Kidogo tupigwe.
We were almost beaten.
Toka.
The phone to the car. This is a Catholic church. It was so hard.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But you have the peace. They came and they prayed. I was not praying
shouting.
I just said
that
I was not calling somebody. I did get protection.
To put the
it became an issue. I asked one question. The priest that preached, his preaching says this.
Kuna watu wako hapa,
the people that are here, they don't speak to each other. But this funeral, you should teach us to have a relationship. Before I leave this house, I thought everybody
ate.
I want to preach to
wale, wale, wale,
the
leader.
They say to declare, they cannot speak to each other. They rose so hard on me.
Sisi wote ni wa Kristo.
All of us are Christians.
Hata ile ile Yohana 17.
Even John 16.
Kwamba Mungu ninawaombea wawe na umoja. Kama sisi tulivyo umoja.
In one accord as us in one accord.
Hawajui wala waifahamu.
They do not even understand it.
Ili uishi maisha ya amani.
For you to live a life of peace.
Anasema mshauri wa ajabu.
He said a wonderful counselor.
Huzuni yetu ameibeba.
Our sorrows he has carried.
Ameitwika huzuni yetu.
He carried all our sorrows.
Kujitwika huzuni yetu.
Carry our sorrows.
Ni wewe kujua kusimama naye.
It's for you to know how to stand.
Ni wewe kujua kutembea naye.
It's for you to know how to walk with it.
Siku moja tumeenda Marangu.
One day went to Marangu.
Sio Marangu, Kibosho.
In Kibosho, sorry.
Tumefika.
We reached over there.
Tuko watumishi wengi.
We were many ministers.
Mwamposa alikuweko.
Mwamposa was there.
Askofu Madulu alikuweko.
Bishop Madulu was there.
Mimi nilikuweko.
I was there.
Nafikiri na Mama Zablon alikuweko na Mama Mtembe alikuweko.
Mama Mtembe was there.
Na wachungaji wengine walikuwa kina ukoo wachungaji kama 10.
We were like 10 pastors.
Tumefika pale. Kwanza njiani walipojua tunakuja wakaweka magogo.
When the new were coming they put a log on the road.
Wakatoliki wakagawa viroba.
The Catholics they gave out the.
Kuna pombe fulani iko kwenye vipakiti vidogo.
Okay, they gave the small sackets of alcohol.
Wakaweka magogo barabarani hakuna mahali pa kupita.
They put the logs on the road nowhere to pass.
Sasa Askofu Madume unajua alikuwa ni yuko ni kiongozi jeshini.
You know Bishop Madume was leader there.
Akampigia simu nani RPC.
He called the RPC.
Akamwambia kitu gani kinaendelea.
So what is happening here?
Wakatuma watu waondoe le magogo.
They sent people to remove the logs.
Tukapita.
We passed.
Lakini yule padri hakukubali.
But that priest not accept.
Tuko kwenye ule msiba.
When that funeral.
Vijana wa kanisa la Katoliki.
The youth of the Catholic Church.
Walikuja wako wameshika bia.
They came having beer.
Mahali tulipokaa wanadondosha bia nguni na pasuka maji ya bia yanatumwagikia.
When they are throwing down the bottles of beer.
Hata wao wakaja wakamuingiza.
And the beer was.
Wakatumia jukwaa letu.
They use a
wakatumia speaker zetu.
They use a speaker
wakatumia
mic
zetu.
Use a mic
kuongoza ile ibada.
To lead that service.
Tulinyamaza.
You wait silent.
Si kwa sababu hatuwezi kupigana.
It's not that you cannot fight.
Si kwa sababu hatuna nguvu.
It's not that you don't have the power.
Bali tunajua.
But we know.
Mtu akisha kufa.
When someone dies.
Anapita kwenye hukumu.
He goes to judgment.
Bila baada ya kifo hukumu.
The Bible say after death is judgment.
Sisi sio kama Wakatoliki.
We are not like the Catholics.
Wanaombea marehemu baada ya kufa.
They are praying for the dead.
Sisi ukishakata roho biashara yako imekwisha.
When you die your issue is over.
Tunafanya ibada.
We are doing a service.
Kwa sababu ya kitu kimoja.
Because of only one thing.
Waliokuwa pale na wenyewe wa
those that are there should not cry also. You wait silent.
But
the trials you take that's why you find the ability to
born
again. Your husband is not born again. We are coming, don't come to
say
we know the issues that happen. Those people are born in the flesh.
Najua wanakuharibia siku yako kabisa.
They tend to spoil your entire day.
Wanaichafua siku yako kabisa.
They tend to destroy
your day. Unajua kile kinaenda kwenye gara sana lioni.
Just I was going to invite God and say look at her, look at her.
Eti lioni. Unajua niligeuka nikamwangalia.
I turned and I said looked.
Hapo nikamwambia Jennifer tulie. Mimi wanatabia kusemanga na Jennifer.
For me, I normal have an issue saying Jennifer calm down, calm down.
Nikapakia wale wachache kwenye gari.
I took the few into the car.
Nikatoa gari hata kabla maiti haijaondoka.
I removed my car before the body was removed. Tell your neighbor those are challenges.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But we have a lot of peace. We have a lot of peace.
Unakwazika mwanangu.
You are getting
kwa sababu humjui Yesu.
Because you know Jesus.
Huyu Yesu tunayeongea habari zake.
The Jesus you're talking about.
Haumjui.
You do not know about him.
Sawa na Ayubu.
You are like Job.
Ayubu naye alikuwa hivyo hivyo.
Job was just like
him. Mwisho sura ya 42.
In 42.
Anasema Bwana.
He said Lord.
Nilikuwa nasikia habari zako.
I was hearing about you.
Lakini leo.
But today.
Nimekuona kwa macho.
I've seen you by my eyes.
Lazima ufike mahali.
You must reach your Lord.
Instead
you have a desire
of seeing
Jesus as
you
preach about every day.
Of
seeing this God.
Even
things you understand. You can be able to see on the other side. Because faith is having a
sure
of the expected thing. Is a substitute of unseen things.
So
the neighbor is a substitute of the unseen. The substitute
ya mambo yasionekana
of the unseen.
Kwa maana ya imani.
That is the meaning of faith.
Ni bayana.
Is a substitute
ya mambo yasionekana
of the unseen.
Tunaamini.
We believe.
Kwamba sisi na nyumba zetu tutaokoka.
We are not found of God.
Hata ungenigeuza vipi.
Even if you turn it
around. Hata ungeniambia vipi.
Even if you tell me how.
Nina uhakika.
I'm so confident.
Watoto wangu watamkiri
My children confess to you. Don't allow them to die. But here you are. The confess Jesus and serve you. Don't you know the robbers get born again into the prisons? How many people get saved into the prisons? Pastor Kilongora on Tuesday. I think most of you text him.
Hallelujah.
When I was doing the ministry of the kids, one of the ministers I used to invite is one of them. We blended a lot. He had a one tent church. He had a sponsor from Canada. He was a very good pastor. And he knows how to preach. So all my children seniors, when we are using we had a session on ITV or the kids session. We used to bring kids here to Moshi. I used to the guests of
Moshi.
I fill them with kids and the mantra. I used to camp 1 week. That pastor, I believe maybe it's just God. He entered into robbery of the bank of CRDB. All the banks that were robbed in Arusha, Moshi, he was the mastermind. Because after he came from the prison, he came in this altar. He led it for 1,500 people who were in Kisongo. 1,500 people in Kisongo. They got born again because of Pastor Jumanne
Kilongola.
I don't know what he did again.
Akatoka magereza.
He came out of prison.
Akarudi duniani.
He came back here.
Akaka.
He came.
Hallelujah. Ni kweli alikuwa ni jambazi lakini bado alitoka.
He was a robber still he came out.
Akafanya ujambazi mwingine wa mwisho.
The last robbery.
Dar es Salaam ambayo ilikuwa mbaya kuliko wote.
Which was worse than even the mission.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Akakamatwa.
He was caught.
Kwanza akachukua watoto wake akawapeleka kuna shule moja iko huko Mshono Kijenge. Ya huyu mwenye Macmillan. Inaitwa nini ile shule? St. Thomas.
He took them to a school in St. Thomas.
The
children were
primary.
He paid the school fees until a primary setting. And he disappeared. He went to Congo. In Congo he was gotten. He was brought here. As we speak now.
It's
in Kisongo. I met him in Kisongo, they broke his legs and they're torturing him. But he's a big preacher in Kisongo. And he's a very good preacher. When I
say
he's a good preacher, he's a really good man. And there's nobody who can pass through him and
not.
When he speaks, when he says the robber, you can't believe. Tell your neighbor. The Barnabas until today they exist. You don't understand. Do you think Barnabas is in heaven? Who told you that?
Barnabas continued.
Barnabas wanted to burn the entire Rome.
To
reach the last time.
He
wanted to sacrifice.
He
said, Jesus now is the Lord. You can't
now
put my head down and
Barnabas.
Barnabas was
up
the difference that Jesus was down. And Peter copied from Barnabas. Why was he permitted? He was
doing
the way of the first prophet. He was doing the
kind
of
baptism.
Confusing everybody. Tell your neighbor, God has many meanings. That's judge anybody. Because you will not be taken to the
prison.
There will be no pastors in the prison.
And God has ministers in
the prison. What am I trying to say?
Kama mtoto wako ni
when your child is a
boy, kule magereza,
the prison you will be led to cry. In the prison. Think God is working
for the prison.
Then the prison, they are pastors.
There are people
that are saying in power of the prison.
It's
the one that loses the power of the prison. The pastor are students of Bishop Maboya.
Hallelujah.
Jesus has his own way. Don't look at your children. You are mad because they came when you
were born.
Prepare a table for him. Your husband has come, he's very
glad.
Today's Christmas, put a plate of food in
his table.
Don't say, Mom, I'm doing it
now.
The Bible says that the Son of God.
Ebu tubebe moyo ule wa Kristo.
Kama
Kristo angetuangalia kama sisi tunavyoangalia. Hakutupasike kuwa na hata mmoja ameketi mahali
hapa.
Lakini Kristo akutuangalia kwa jicho. Ambalo sisi tunaangalia watu. Kristo ametuangalia kwa jicho la tofauti. Ambalo Mungu anasema ni ile ile. Iliyokuwepo ndani ya Kristo Yesu.
Njoiwe
ndani yetu sisi.
The one should be.
Ni lazima tuibadilishe ile nia.
You have to change the inner thing.
Si kwamba hakuna maumivu.
It's not that there's no pain.
Yapo. Lakini pamoja na maumivu tunayoyasikia, tuwe na nia ya Yesu Kristo.
Biblia
inasema be constantly renewed in the spirit of your minds. Kinachobadilishwa ni nia iliyoko katika akili, in the spirit of your mind. Moyo wako unakataa.
Your heart is disturbed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lakini ni Christmas.
But it's Christmas.
Jesus is coming.
Yes, to anarudi.
Kwenye ibada ya kwanza.
In the first service.
Nikasema tujifunze mtini.
He said you have to learn from the tree.
Tusipoweza kujifunza majina na nyakati.
If you don't know about the season and the time.
Inaweza ikawa uwezi kufuatilia mambo ya habari.
Maybe not pursuing about the issue of the news.
Na habari kidogo imekuwa imebana.
And there's a lot of stoppage upon the news. But when you have gone to school,
at least to make a bundle.
You should put on the bundle.
Angalia kitu gani kinaendelea.
Look what is happening to the news.
Ili uweze kusoma majira na
nyakati. So you know the season and the time.
Yesu anasema jifunzeni mtini.
Jesus said, learn from me.
Anasema ombeeni Israel.
He said, pray for Israel.
Iombe Jerusalem.
Pray for Jerusalem.
Ili uweze kupata amani.
So you may have the peace.
Nawe utabarikiwa.
And shall be blessed.
Amani Jerusalem.
The peace in Jerusalem. The Arabs don't recognize before the Israelites. Today they recognize him officially. That Israel is a true nation.
Hallelujah.
It means peace has come down. Because all these
enemies
that are oppressing Israel, they are recognizing him like a nation. They say, let's look upon the
time.
Today is Dubai. They are landing 3 times a week.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Zinatua Israel.
They are landing in Israel. The Muscat plane. The Bahrain plane.
They
are all going to Israel. And the national places are going to the
United Nations.
Recently, I saw the footballers. They want to Dubai to play football. You know the King of Kings is about to come back. Nobody knows the season and the time.
Lakini lazima tujue.
But you have to know.
Harakati za mpinga Kristo zimeanza.
The plan of the Antichrist has started.
Ni kweli wanasema mnyonge mnyongeni.
It's true they say the evil may be evil.
Lakini haki yake mpende.
But giving the true justification.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Magufuli ametutangazia hakuna chanjo.
Magufuli has told us there is no vaccine.
Amesema sisi tutatumia dawa za kienyeji.
He said we are going to use our herbs.
Sindio? Watangaza jamani.
That's what they declared.
Tangaze kwa kimataifa.
Ya Divine International.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. If you have not gotten that, I'll throw that into the group. Because it's something good. It is true.
Lakini.
But.
Utatokaje nje ya mipaka ya Tanzania?
How do you get out of the boundaries of Tanzania?
Bila hiyo chanjo.
Without the vaccine.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sio kama unanielewa.
I don't know if you understand.
Tunakuwa hakuna kuuza wala kununua.
There is no selling nor buying.
Na hiyo chanjo,
and that vaccine,
kazi yake kubwa ni kubadilisha DNA.
His work is to change the DNA.
Kwa wale ambao kwa wanaangalia kwenye mitandao,
for those that are following over the news,
wataona maraisi waliopata chanjo.
They have seen the president got the
vaccine. Ile sindano,
the injection,
ilikuwa ina plastiki juu.
It had a plastic on top.
Ina maana walichoma sindano yao kulikuwa hakuna sindano.
They injected them, there was no medicine.
Hapana kwa kwenye mitandao wanaelewa wanachoongea.
For those that are following over
the news, wameona hiyo chanjo ya rais wa Ufaransa pamoja na
the vaccine of the president of England and also of France.
Wamechoma sindano ambayo ina plastiki.
They injected them.
Kwenye ile skrini tunakuwa na plastiki inavalishwa pale.
They sealed them with a plastic inside.
Wamewekewa sindano lakini ile plastiki bado ipo.
They have been injected with a plastic still there.
Kwa hiyo ile ni kudanganya watu
duniani. To deceive the people in the world.
Kwa maana haitabadilika.
Because it's not changed.
Duniani kuna watu bilioni 7.2 kitu.
There are 7 billion plus people in the world.
Na wanatakiwa wabaki watu bilioni 1 tu.
The world only remain 1 billion people. Then I'm asking, how are you going to travel? You know, East Africa, we are just like twins. I was preaching to people the first time because most of them go to
Namanga.
There is a way they get the certificate that they put in that thing onto the nose. They laughed so much into the first
service.
There were Kenyans going to Dubai.
Wakafanya hicho wanachokifanya wa Tanzania maana sisi ni ndugu moja.
They did that the way Tanzanians do because they
are like Dubai.
We just went to Dubai.
Wakakuta Mwarabu amebadilika.
You find the Arab has changed.
Akasema watu wote waliokuja na hii ndege.
He said all people that have come with this plane.
Kenya Airways.
KKQ.
Warudie kipimo.
They should repeat doing the exercise.
Wakakuta wa Kenya 10 wana corona.
They found 10 Kenyans have COVID.
Wamefungwa miaka miwili.
They have been prison 2 years.
Na hakuna Mkenya anaruhusiwa tena Dubai.
And no Kenyan is permitted to go to Dubai.
Biashara ya Mkenya Dubai imefungwa.
They grab the issues of the Kenyans.
Sasa najaribu kupata picha.
I want to get you get a picture.
Kwamba tumeenda wapi?
Where are we going?
Ina maana kwamba ni kwetu naweza kuheka hiyo vaccine.
It's true you can not take the vaccine.
Lakini manaje wafanya biashara muende mkalini.
It means the business people have to go. Maybe Tanzania is a refuge land.
Lakini kwa wafanyabiashara wanaovuka mipaka.
But the business is crossing over the boundaries.
Wakati wa kufanya biashara wamekwisha.
You have time to do business is over.
Lakini Biblia inasema.
And the Bible says.
Hata sasa yuko yule mpinga Kristo.
Even right now there's an antichrist.
Lakini yuko azuiaye.
But there's one who is able to stop.
Ambaye Biblia inaita azuiaye ni kanisa.
The Bible says the one who
stops. Kanisa tuna uwezo.
The church of the power.
Kuzuia hivi harakati.
And don't think that it's
man. Tunavuka kizazi chetu.
To cross over this. The power is there. Because
they will
say, even now,
but
there's one who stops. Who is the church?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Nilikuwa na mwangalia mtumishi wa Mungu, Pastor Chris.
I was looking at the man of God, Pastor Chris.
Sasa hivi ndio ni kama ndo msemaji wa dunia.
He's just like the one that speaks on behalf of the nation for all the Christians.
Anasema.
He says.
What? Sijui kama ni Mungu anamwambia kile ninachojua.
I don't know what that says, but what I know.
Hakuna anayejua siku wala saa.
Nobody knows the time and hour.
Lakini nafikiri wote tunamjua Pastor Chris wa Love Well.
But all of us know a Pastor Chris for the morning.
Anasema haitafika miaka 10.
He says it won't pass 10 years.
Kabla Yesu ajarudi.
Before Jesus comes back.
Hatujui.
We don't know.
Inaweza ikawa ni leo.
Maybe it's today.
Inaweza ikawa ni kesho.
Maybe tomorrow.
Kwa maana kanisa itaingia kwenye dhiki kuu.
Because the church won't enter the great tribulation.
Lakini inakujia itabaki.
But will you remain?
Nilikuwa naongea na mama yangu mama Mwakasege.
I was speaking to my mama mama Mwakasege.
Kuna kitu fulani alikuwa amenunua.
There's something she has bought.
Akasema inabidi nikiweke haraka haraka.
Let me put it so fast.
Naona Yesu anarudi asiye akanikuta sijakitumia.
I said, Jesus, may come back because they're using it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. In other words,
it's
the time to make our ways right.
It's
the time to put our legs right. You have confused yourself
with
the
Lord.
You have used to Christ the Lord. But those of you know the season of time, the red light, the red blinking.
Yes,
Jesus is coming back. Leave alone our
mission.
Make sure you are straight. Just don't remain.
He's
not
going
to have to sing that song. What will I do? What will I say?
Akirudi Bwana Yesu.
When Jesus comes back,
I've
been left to the
sinners.
And yet I'm saying I'm born again. Somebody can make yourself
but
this Christmas,
I
want to tell you, if you have high time,
if
you have time to make things right, make right this
God.
We don't have enough time. Because on the time,
and they
say 10 years old,
and
they say the
only thing.
When you hear the prophecies, one thing that I know, the great tribulation I was looking to Australia.
Watu wote waliopata chanjo ya corona.
All those that are vaccine of COVID.
Maana sasa kule ni lazima.
Because there is a mask.
Wamepata HIV.
They've gotten HIV.
Walikuwa ni wazima.
They were okay.
Wengine ni wazee kwa sababu walianza na wazee na watu ni magonjwa.
Other people.
Fikiria.
Just imagine.
Wamelazimishwa kwanza hawakutaka.
They've been forced.
Kwa sababu wao taifa lililoanza.
Because the first nation began.
Lakini wote.
But all of them.
Sikwambii uongo katakatia kwenye mtandao.
I want to lie. You go to
chanjo ya corona Australia.
COVID,
wote wamepata HIV
all of them are positive and did not are not positive before HIV.
Lazima uelewe lengo.
You must know the intention.
Lengo la ugonjwa
ni intention of this disease.
Leo kuna airport kama nne zimefungwa duniani.
There are four airports.
Uingereza, South Africa, Ubelgiji,
Belgium,
na Spain.
And Spain.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Na Italy nao wameshafunga.
And Italy also.
Corona imerudi upya.
COVID
is anasema corona ya safari.
Ni
kali kuliko ile ya awali.
Alafu
inakamata vijana.
And gets the youth.
Sasa ile ukaja kutoka kwa wazee kaja.
How did it turn from the ordinary people to the youth?
Tunajua lazima tujiongeze.
You must add our song.
Tulimuomba Mungu.
We pray to God.
Nzige wasivuke mpaka wa
Tanzania.
Nzige walizunguka Afrika Mashariki yote.
Locusts went to East Africa.
Hawakuingia Tanzania.
They didn't come to Tanzania.
Tuliomba kabla ya maombi ya kitaifa.
We prayed before the nation prayer.
Na Mungu alisikia.
And God heard.
Kwa wale waliokuwepo kwenye maombi yao.
And those and those prayers.
Tuliomba siku nzima kuanzia saa 12 asubuhi.
From morning.
Mungu alisema.
God said.
Na tuliandika.
And we wrote it down.
Mungu akatulika mwomba Mungu kwa habari ya corona.
We pray to God because of COVID.
Akasema ametuponya.
He said he has healed.
Kabla taifa lijao.
Before the nation pray.
Tulimwambia Mungu atulinde na wale Nairobi fly walioingia Kenya.
We pray for God to protect us from Nairobi fly from
Mungu
Kenya.
Mungu alitulinda.
God protected us.
Tunaweza kuzuia hii kitu
inayokuja. We have the power to stop whatever is coming.
Lakini lazima tuielewe.
But you have to understand.
Lazima tutambue ni adui. Tusipotambua.
Tukawa
kama watu ambao hawajaenda shule.
Going to school,
he
shall take us.
Because
we need to travel.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We need to travel. I laughed a lot like 3 weeks ago. There's one way Bishop Boy went to a conference in Kenya. There's where he crossed at Namanga.
Akafanikiwa.
And he succeeded.
Tukacheka.
We laughed.
Ikaja safari ya Sudan.
Now he came the trip to Sudan.
Kulikuwa kuna mlango wa kutokea.
There is no way to pass.
Kabidi aende Mount Meru.
He had to go to Mount Meru.
Wakamuingizia zile fimbo kichwani.
They put those sticks into his nose.
Alilalamika siku nzima.
He complained the whole day.
Kila kigeuka.
Wherever he turns.
Sasa. Hiyo vaccine inakuaje?
Na wala bado vaccine.
Manake tuache kuhubiri injili. Manake tuache kwenda kuleta mizigo China na Uturuki na Uingereza na Marekani.
Gospel is it possible from Turkey?
Lazima tupambane. Yaani tukipata hata watu 10 walio maanisha.
Tupige like chini kwa
vipindi na tunaingia hata kama taifa zima likanyamaza.
Hallelujah. I have my daughter, she's called Kelly. Her big prayers. Jesus is coming back tomorrow.
Amen.
That's our prayers. I don't know why she's praying like that. Jesus will come back tomorrow. She says it's okay. But I love heaven. I want to continue to live here in the world.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because Abraham
has like 600 years down there. Moses
4,000
years.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, ana miaka toka amekufa na kufufuka 2000 na.
Jesus has 2,000 years plus.
Tuweza tukakasa na kule kaburini.
We can stay a lot of the grave.
Acha tuishiishi na hapa duniani.
Let's just live here the world to world.
Lakini ni tuishiishi hapa duniani
kitu. But to live here the world.
Lazima tuelewe ni majira na nyakati.
Because of the season and the time.
Kwa sababu tuna uwezo wa kustopisha.
Because of the power to stop.
Kusimamisha.
Or stop it.
Au wa kuchelewesha.
Or delay.
Kama ingekuwa hakuna uwezo kwa mwanadamu.
There was no power upon man.
Wakati nikienda kumaliza.
As it go to finish.
Yesu Kristo.
Jesus Christ.
Asingemhitaji Ana na Simeoni.
You need Ana and Simeon.
Ili aweze kuzaliwa.
So that can be born.
Angezaliwa tu.
Was just only born.
Lakini Biblia ninayosoma.
But the Bible that we say.
Inaendelea kuna mtu alikuwa anaitwa Ana.
There's someone called Anna.
Na Simeon.
And Simon.
Waliomba na kufunga.
They prayed and fasted.
Ndani ya hekalu.
In the temple.
Kwa miaka mpaka yule mama akafika miaka 80.
Until the lady she was 80 years old.
Alafu Yesu akazaliwa.
And Jesus was born.
Walikuwa wanaombea nini?
What were they praying for?
Kuzaliwa kwa Kristo.
The birth of Jesus.
Katika ulimwengu wa roho.
In the spiritual realm.
Hakuna kinachofanyika bila kuatimia.
Nothing that goes.
Tunataka kushinda ushindi wa kweli.
What are the true victory?
Nataka kuvuka kwa kweli.
We want to cross through.
Lazima tuhakikishe tunang'ana.
Make sure we strive.
Lazima tuhakikishe tunapambana.
Make sure we fight.
Ili niapo basi.
So that also.
Wale wa nyumbani kwetu ambao wamefanya maamuzi.
Those who are household of God receive Jesus.
Waweze kufanya maamuzi.
Be able to make a
Simama tu mahali uliko.
Arise on your feet.
Yesu Kristo bado ni Bwana.
Jesus is still God.
Na umejazwa Roho Mtakatifu.
Yanyo
tu mikono yako juu.
Raise up your hands.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yanyo tu mikono yako juu.
Just raise up your hands.
Yanyo tu mikono yako juu.
Raise up your hand. Jesus, you are able.
Wakati huo ninaomba mpiga keyboard.
Na after keyboard.
Aniletee tenzi ya rohoni.
To bring the hymn.
Number 82.
Number 82.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tutaimba wote kwa pamoja.
We shall sing together.
Number 82.
82 the book and 82 the hymn. Just speak in tongues, raise up your hand. You accept that everybody is filled with the Spirit of God before the end of the year. Hallelujah.
Hebu sema tu na Mungu.
Just speak to God.
Wewe mwenyewe unajua.
You surely know.
Mahali ulipoangukia.
The place where you're falling.
Mahali ambapo roho ya mazoea.
The spirit of familiarity with
God. Iliingia ndani. Ujisikii vibaya kuchelewa ibadani.
You don't feel bad coming here.
Ujisikii vibaya kukaa nyumbani na kufua siku ya Jumapili.
You don't feel bad to stay at home to wash your clothes.
Badala ya kwenda nyumbani mwa Bwana.
And so go and make it.
Nami nina kitu cha kumwambia Bwana.
I believe something better.
Inaweza ikawa kabisa kuna vitu havijakaa sawa.
The things are right with you.
Kwa wale ambao vitu kabisa vijakaa sawa.
As for those that things are right with you.
Ninaomba waweze kupita mbele.
This is just coming forward.
Naomba wapite mbele tuombe pamoja.
This is coming forward, pray together.
Yesu Kristo anarudi.
Jesus is coming back.
Utake usitake anarudi.
Want it or not.
Anarudi lini mimi sijui.
You sign back when I don't
stop.
But you surely know. One thing that I know is coming back. The mind of man is coming back.
Unahitaji kutengenezwa na Mungu.
You need to make things right with God.
Wengine wote funga macho yako.
Everybody close your eyes.
Unahitaji kumwangalia nani anapita
mbele. You don't look at someone.
Lakini unajua maisha yako yaliyakaa sawa
sawa. But your life is alright.
Hata Yesu akija leo haurudi.
He just comes back
today. Maana ya Christmas ndio hii.
This is the true meaning of Christmas.
Yesu kuzaliwa ndani yako.
Jesus born in you.
Yesu Kristo kuzaliwa ndani yako.
Jesus born in you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ezekiel aliambiwa tengeneza mambo ya nyumbani mwako.
Until behind the raise up your hands.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Just meditate the power of the cross.
Tafakari yale ambayo Kristo alifanya.
Meditate what Jesus did.
Alafu piga picha kwamba Yesu leo anarudi.
Just meditate that Jesus is coming today.
Yeye atakuwa mmoja wapo wa
kumlaki.
Ni maswali ya kujiuliza.
It's a question to ask yourself.
Kama unaona kwamba uwezi kujijibu.
If know you can answer your song.
Naomba tu upite mbele.
Just come before.
Pita tu mbele.
Just come before.
Pita tu mbele.
Just come before.
Bado nasikia ndani yangu kuna watu wanatakiwa kupita.
I just feel inside me that God wants to.
Bado nasikia ndani yangu kuna watu wanatakiwa
kutengeneza. I feel inside that I need to make things right with God.
Pita tu mbele.
Just come before.
Kwamba je nitakuwa mmoja.
Will I be a man?
Wa wale kondoo.
Of the number.
Yesu atakaporudi.
When Jesus comes back.
Nitakuwa mmoja wa.
Will I be one of the number?
Kweli nitaingia mbinguni.
Will I really go to heaven?
Kweli nitamwona Kristo.
Will I see Jesus?
Kweli nitamwona Bwana.
Will I see God?
Nitamwona Yesu.
Will I see Jesus?
Ni maswali ya kujiuliza
ndani. The question you need to ask.
Ni maswali ya kujiuliza ndani.
The question you need to ask.
Ni maswali ya kujiuliza
ndani. The question you need to ask.
Atarudi Yesu.
When Jesus comes back.
Kweli nitamwona.
Will I be a man of the number?
Wakati tunaendelea kuimba wimbo
huu. As we just sing this song.
Naomba tuendelee kupita mbele.
Just come in for me.
Akarudi Yesu. Amen.
Seven times. child of 15 years. The blood that is that. The blood that is
God.
Speak to your soul. Everybody that is here.
I am a motor shaker. Samantha Shamanibo Sakatu.